back to Frappe Academy. Remember us? We are Frappe Furniture, your peers in setting up a new ERPNext account. In the last video, we added some basic information to our ERPNext account and created a few transactions. We also saw the different modules that hold different documents. Now, these documents, as we saw, represent the information that is carried throughout the system. Whenever we wanted to add any information to ERPNext, it was done via these documents like item, customer, supplier, etc. Each document that you see is a DocType. So, in this video, we are going to learn how DocTypes control the information in each document and other concepts related to it. Everything you see inside ERPNext, whether it's a customer, invoice, or an item, is defined as a DocType. So let's dig deeper into DocTypes. A DocType would define the layout of the document form to the user. Every field, column, section, or table that you see in a document looks like how it does because it was structured that way in its DocType. Which is why we say that DocTypes are the building blocks of ERPNext. Confused? Let me explain. Let's assume ERPNext is a Lego set. Every DocType has multiple fields in it which capture the information. So each field in a DocType is one Lego brick. The bricks when stacked on one another make objects like these. Think of each of these objects as one DocType, like the item document in ERPNext. When many objects like these are placed together, they make a Lego set. And many DocTypes like item, customer, and sales order are linked together to make ERPNext. Let us search for DocType in the awesome bar to see how it works. We said everything in ERPNext is a DocType, right? Let me start by showing how a DocType can be created. The DocTypes for all the different documents will be listed down here. Now, at Frappe Furniture, a bunch of my business comes from the online orders that we receive. For these orders, I also need to record the feedback from my customers. Let's check if ERPNext can provide me that. I will type in customer feedback in the awesome bar and I cannot find anything like that. This means there is no DocType for it. But hey, I can see a new button in the DocType list, which means I can create my own DocType here. I will add the name customer feedback. As we know, the different DocTypes are grouped together in the modules, so I will add this one to the CRM module. I will quickly add a couple of fields here. A customer field, which will be a link field type. A date field, which will be a date field type. A field called rating, wherein the field type would be rating. And an additional feedback field, which will be a text field type. I will also make the customer field and the rating field mandatory. Once I've saved this, the DocType will appear when I search for it using the awesome bar. Let's open a new tab and see how the customer feedback document looks like. You can make changes to its DocType here, and those changes will be reflected in the next tab. Because I've enabled the mandatory option, these two fields will be highlighted in red. And without adding information to these fields, you will not be able to save the record. Also, when you try to make a record for the customer feedback DocType, you will notice that each field has a different kind of input mechanism. Everything that we enter in these fields is controlled by field types. There can be some fields where I can select records from other DocTypes, like in this case, customer. For this field, the customer records will be fetched to selection. Then there is a date field where the input can only go in date format. For the rating field, since we have added the field type as rating, the input here is in the form of stars. Lastly, for the additional feedback field, the input can be added in simple text form. Let's save this record. There is a long list of all the different types of fields present in ERPNext, and you can find the information on the field types by following the link in the description. You can search for it on Google as well. We will explore more about the field types and other components of a DocType in our upcoming videos. Meanwhile, you can open the standard DocTypes and see how fields are structured there as well. For now, to summarize the video, I would say that ERPNext is driven by DocTypes. The DocTypes are the backend controllers of all documents that are driven by fields. So a number of fields together make one DocType, and a number of DocTypes enable us to link information, thus becoming the building blocks of ERPNext. I hope that this video will help you understand the basic structure of ERPNext elements, just like it helped Frappe furniture. We will meet again to learn how to import your existing data into your new ERPNext account. Until then, we hope that you keep going through the user manual in case of queries and reach out to us in case of additional support requirements. Do let us know your thoughts about the video in the comments.